The Bible reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. You know, brothers, that our visit to you was not a failure. We had previously suffered and been insulted in Philippi, as you know. But with the help of our God, we dared to tell you his gospel in spite of strong opposition. For the appeal we make does not spring from error or impure motives, nor are we trying to trick you. On the contrary, we speak as men approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel. We are not trying to please men, but God, who tests our hearts. You know we never use flattery, nor did we put on a mask to cover up greed. God is our witness. We were not looking for praise from men, not from you or anyone else. As apostles of Christ, we could have been a burden to you, but we were gentle among you, like a mother caring for her little children. We loved you so much that we were delighted to share with you not only the gospel of God, but our lives as well, because you had become so dear to us. Surely you remember, brothers, our toil and hardship. We work night and day in order not to be a burden to anyone while we preach the gospel of God to you. You are witnesses, and so is God, of how holy, righteous, and blameless we were among you who believed. For you know that we dealt with each of you as a father deals with his own children, encouraging, comforting, and urging you to live lives worthy of God, who calls you into his kingdom and glory. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Very good evening once again to all of you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, and truly the Lord be with you in this season and time.
各位弟兄姐妹,大家晚上好,欢迎你们来参加我们的崇拜,愿主与你同在,特别是在这个的季节里面。Thank
you for joining us again online and also to follow us in our study from the book of 1 Thessalonians.
感谢你们来参加我们的崇拜,然后呢,跟我们一起来看这个帖撒罗尼迦前书的信息系列。
Now let's begin by reviewing the overall structure of 1 Thessalonians.
所以作为开始呢,让我们先来复习帖撒罗尼迦前书的整个架构。
As you can see, that 1 Thessalonians has 5 chapters, can be divided into 2 parts.
所以呢,我们能够看到的帖撒罗尼迦前书总共是有5章,可以分成两个部分。
Now the first 3 chapters are reflective in nature.
所以第一到第三章呢,它是属于反思性的。
Now Paul looks back at what they and the Thessalonian believers went through, and he thanked God for his good grace and also the believers' faith.
所以在这里呢,保罗他就回顾他们还有帖撒罗尼迦信徒所经历的一切,而他也为神的恩典和信徒的信心来感谢神。
And we saw last week when Paul reflected on the Thessalonians' faith in God.
所以在上个星期的信息呢,我们就能够看到这一点,就是保罗他就回顾了帖撒罗尼迦信徒对神的信心。Their
faith was genuine and strong.
他们的信心是真诚的,刚强的。
And they were even willing to suffer for their faith.
他们甚至是愿意为他们的信心受苦。Now
they were not discouraged or backslided by all the persecutions and attacks.
他们并没有因为所面对的所有逼迫和攻击而感到灰心或者是倒退。In
fact, we learned that they even thrived in their faith and witness.
然后呢,我们看到他们甚至是在他们的信心和见证上茁壮的成长。
Now this week we will learn as Paul further reflect on their own ministry in Thessalonica.
所以在这个星期呢,我们就会看到保罗他会更进一步的来去回顾他们在帖撒罗尼迦的时候的事工。Now
he looked back on how they had conducted themselves and ministered among the believers.
他就思想到他们在信徒当中如何的服事,然后他们有怎样的行事为人。Now
in this chapter, Paul took the opportunity to testify and even defended their ministries in Thessalonica.
所以在这一章呢,保罗他也会趁机会见证和维护他们在帖撒罗尼迦的事工。Now
the reason for doing so was that because there were some people who were against the Christian faith and their ministries.
他之所以如此做呢，是因为有一群的人，他们就是在反对这个基督教信仰，还有他们的事工。
And these people falsely accused Paul and his companions for deceiving the people and committing treason against Caesar and the Roman government.
所以这一群的人呢，他们是不真实的来去指控保罗还有他的团队，然后呢，就说他们是欺骗人的，然后呢，也对这个凯撒和罗马政府犯了叛国罪。
So there is a little shift here.
所以在这里呢，我们会有一点的转移。
While we look at the faith and the lives of the believers in chapter 1, now we turn our attention to the lives and ministries of pastors and leaders.
所以在第一章的时候呢，我们就看到信徒的信心和生命。所以今天在第二章呢，我们将会来看到牧师还有基督徒领袖的信心和生命。
Now, Paul, in defense of all that they had done and also ministered in Thessalonica, he used three metaphors.
所以保罗他在维护他们在帖撒罗尼迦的事工的时候呢，他就使用了三个的比喻。
And the metaphors are as a steward, meaning to say an approved workman, parents, and also herald to describe their ministry.
他就使用了管家就是神所认可的工人，父母和使者来描述他们的事工。
And these three characteristics can also be used by all of us today to evaluate our church and pastoral ministries.
所以今天我们也能够使用这三个的特征来去评估我们的教会还有我们的牧者事工。
These serve as a plumb line or standards.For all who are serving God.
所以这是所有服侍神的人的一个的标准或者是准绳。
These are the characteristics of a transparent ministry in Christ.
这是在耶稣基督里面有一个透明的事工所具有的特征。
So the first we look is a steward.
所以首先我们来看管家。
Or meaning an approved workman.
意思就是说是神所认可的工人。
I would like Annie to read in Chinese.
我们来看帖撒罗尼迦前书二章一到四节。弟兄们，你们自己原晓得，我们进到你们那里并不是突然的。我们从前在腓立比被害受辱，这是你们知道的。然而还是靠我们的神放开胆量，在大征战中把神的福音传给你们。我们的劝勉不是出于错误，不是出于污秽，也不是用诡诈，但神既然验中了我们，把福音托付我们，我们就照样讲，不是要讨人喜欢，乃是要讨那监察我们心的神喜欢。
Now the first metaphor Paul used here is an approved workman or a steward.
所以在这里保罗所使用的第一个的比喻呢，就是管家或者是神所认可的工人。
A steward is a person who has been entrusted with the management of the master's household or business.
管家呢，就是一个被托付来去管理主人的家或者是家业的人。
It was like Joseph in the Old Testament who was entrusted with the managerial role in Potiphar's household.
这就像在旧约时候的约瑟，那么他在波提凡的家里呢，就被托付这个管理的角色。
And it was also just like Jesus's parable of the talents.
就好像耶稣在这个金明管家的比喻里面。
Now Paul used the word approved workman to mean the same here as a person entrusted with the gospel of Christ.
保罗他在这里呢，他就使用了验证这个词，那么这是和一个被托付基督福音的人有相同的意思。
Here is how Paul described his ministry as a steward.
所以保罗在这里呢，就来去描述他们的事工是如何像这个管家一样。
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 3, he said, "For the appeal we make does not spring from error or impure motives, nor are we trying to trick you."
所以保罗在第三节这里说，我们的劝勉不是出于错误，不是出于污秽，也不是用诡诈。
Now here Paul used three distinctdifferent words to affirm the truthfulness of their ministries.
那么在这里呢，保罗就使用了三个不同的词语来去描述他们事工的真实性。
Each one expressing an a contrast to the false accusations against them.
所以每一个的词语呢，都是在于他们啊，针对他们的这些的指控呢，啊，形成了一个的对比。
Now he first asserts that their message was true and not false or error.
所以呢，他首先呢就强调说，他们的信息是真实的，不是错误或者是谬误的。
Secondly, the manner of their life was pure and godly.Not evil or immoral.
第二就是他们的生活方式是纯洁和敬虔的，不是邪恶和污秽的。
And their method of ministry was clear and honest, not trickery or deceptive.
然后他们的侍奉方式是明确和诚实的，不是诡诈或欺骗的。
And the ministry was evident to all the Thessalonian believers.
所以他们的事工已经向所有帖撒罗尼迦的信徒显明了。
If we read in verse 9, Paul reiterates, Surely you remember, brothers and sisters, our toil and hardship. We work night and day in order not to be a burden to anyone while we preach the gospel of God to you.
保罗在第九节他就重申说，弟兄们，你们纪念我们的辛苦劳碌，昼夜做工，传神的福音给你们，免得叫你们一人受累。
And in this passage, we see that Paul asserted that they were trustworthy in their ministry, and the message of the gospel is the truth that transforms lives.
所以在这节的经文里面呢，我们能够看到保罗他就坚持说，他们在他们的事工上呢是守信的，而耶稣基督的福音呢就是能够来去转化生命的。
Now, my brothers and sisters in Christ, this is the same Christian faith and message that we believe, teach.And preach today.
所以弟兄姐妹，这就是这个基督教的信仰的这个的信息呢，同样是今天我们所相信、所传扬、所教导的一个的信息。
From the very beginning, the Bible is our source of authority and truth.
所以从起初，圣经就是我们这个权威的根源。
It is definitely not as recklessly insinuated by the past politician.Nick Muhammad Zawawi, that our Bible is corrupted or distorted.
这绝对不是如伊斯兰党的这个 Nick Muhammad Zawawi, 他轻率的暗示说我们的圣经是被破坏和被歪曲的。
My brothers and sisters, and my dear friends, the foundation of our Christian faith is built on truth, godliness, and integrity.
弟兄姐妹，我们基督教信仰的根基是建立在真理、敬虔和纯正上。
Now let me add another thing here. The reality is this, that there will be more and more of such lies and accusations against the Christian faith and the church in the days to come.
让我再更进一步的说明这一点。事实上就是在未来的日子里面呢，基督教的信仰将会面对到越来越多的这些谎言和指控。
It will not be any less.
这不会减少。
And we will hear more and more of it.
我们将会听到越来越多。
And the best way to answer and silence all these people is the purity of our message, the godliness of our lives, and the integrity of our ministry.
所以要回答这些人，或者是使这些人闭口无言的最好的方式呢，就是透过我们信息的纯洁，我们生命的敬虔，还有我们事工上的见证。
I'm calling every believers, every Christian,to guard our hearts and to be vigilant, not to let the evil one to catch our heels from deviating from this truth.
所以弟兄姐妹们，我在呼吁每一个人，让我们要警醒，要谨慎自守，不要让恶者抓到我们在偏离啊，就是偏离了真理的这个的痛脚。
That is why Paul reminded Timothy, he's a young pastor, do your best to present yourself to God as one approved, a worker,who does not need to be ashamed, and who correctly handles the word of truth.
这就是为什么保罗他就提醒了提摩太这位年轻的牧者，他说你当竭力在神面前得蒙喜悦，做无愧的工人，按着正义分解真理的道，但要远避世俗的虚谈，因为这等人必进到更不敬虔的地步。
He also added to avoid godless chatter,meaning to say that the empty or vain discussions or debate because those who indulge in it will become more and more ungodly.
他在这一节的经文，他还说你要远避世俗的虚谈，因为当你在更多的参与在里面的时候呢，你就会进到一个更不敬虔的地步里面。
So that is the very first metaphor, a steward or an approved workman.
所以这就是第一个的比喻，就是管家是神所认可的工人。
The second picture is that Paul uses the picture of parents.
所以保罗所使用的第二个的比喻呢，就是父母。
Again, I invite Annie to read this in the Chinese.
帖撒罗尼迦前书第二章第六到十二节。我们做基督的使徒，虽然可以叫人尊重，却没有向你们或向别人求荣耀，只在你们中间存心忍耐，如同母亲乳养自己的孩子。我们即是这样爱你们，不但愿意将神的福音传给你们，连自己的性命也愿意给你们，因你们是我们所疼爱的。你们也晓得我们怎么样劝勉你们，安慰你们，嘱咐你们个人，好像父亲带自己的儿女一样，要叫你们行事，对得起那招你们进他国，得他荣耀的神。
Paul described their ministry like parents to their children.
保罗就描述他们的事工呢，是如同父母对待孩子一样。
Paul and his team's ministry are transparent and pastoral.
保罗和他团队的事工呢，是透明的，而且是带有牧养的性质的。
Now, a mother does not only conceive and gives birth to a child.
那一个的母亲呢，她不仅是怀孕生子，
but she also cares for him, feeds him, and literally shares her whole life with her child.
那么她也会去关爱这个孩子，喂养这个孩子，她基本上呢，就是将她的整个人的生命呢，都和这个孩子分享。
As we read this passage, Paul said that he has every right to claim his rights and privileges as an apostle.
保罗在这节的经文，他说他作为使徒，他可以来去使用他作为使徒所有的这些的权柄和特权。
Yet he did not, but chose to be gentle, like a nursing mother caring for her child, like a father encouraging, comforting, and urging their children to live rightly before God and people.
可是呢，他却没有这样子做，他反倒选择要存心温柔，如同母亲乳养自己的孩子一般，如同父亲对待自己的儿女一般，来去劝勉、安慰、嘱咐他们的孩子，要活出行事为人对得起神和神和人的生命。
Now, in spite of all the accusations, all the false accusations and attacks,Paul did not instigate hatred or division against any people or beliefs.
虽然保罗他面对到许多的攻击、许多的反对，可是呢，他却没有对任何人或者是信仰呢来去挑起这些的仇恨或者是分裂。
He did not stir the Christians to revenge or to violence or rebellion.
他并没有煽动这些的基督徒来去报仇，或者是呢要用暴力和叛乱。
Here, Paul comforted and encouraged them to persevere, to trust God, to honor all peoples, and also to be good examples as salt and light to glorify God in all that they do.
所以在这里呢，保罗他就勉励和安慰安慰这些信徒说，你们要坚忍，要来去信靠神，要尊敬人，要成为好榜样，成为这个光和盐，然后呢，在一切所行的事上都要荣耀神。
Paul and his team also did not take advantage on the church they pastored.
然后呢，保罗和他的团队呢，也没有在他们所牧养的这些的教会上来去取任何的利益。
Instead, they were faithful and sacrificial in pastoral care.
相反的，他们在这个牧养的事工上，他们是忠心和牺牲的。
They were there to serve.And not to be served.
他们去到那里是要去服侍，而不是受人服侍。
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, and my dear friends, this is what we ought to see more and more in our church.
弟兄姐妹，我的朋友们，这是我们在我们的教会里面应该更多看到的。
We must not only be diligent in the works of the Lord, but also in pastoral care.
我们不仅要在神的事工上殷勤，我们也要在牧养的事工上殷勤。
We may be strong, but we can be stronger in our testimony to the world.
我们或许是强大的，可是我们在对于这个世界的见证上是可以变得更加的强大。
We have already learned from Paul the metaphors of a steward, a parent, and now a herald.
所以呢，我们已经在保罗那里呢学习到这个比喻，就是有关于管家、父母。那么现在呢，就是使者。
And 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 13, Paul said, And we also thank God continually, because you received the word of God, which you heard from us. You accepted it not as the word of man, but as it actually is, the word of God, which is at work in you who believe.
帖撒罗尼迦前书二章十三节，为此我们也不住地感谢神，因你们听见我们所传神的道，就领受了，不以为是人的道，乃以为是神的道。这道实在是神的，并且运行在你们心中，并且运行在你们信主的人心中。
A herald is one who proclaims the gospel of Christ.
使者就是一个去传扬耶稣基督福音的人。
Paul and his team preach Christ in spite of opposition and danger.
保罗和他的同伴尽管在面对到危险和反对的时候呢，仍然去传扬基督。
Persecution did not hinder the work of God.
逼迫并没有拦阻到神的工作。
In fact, when we have a strong and living faith, hardship will even accelerate the preaching of the gospel.
其实，当我们拥有一个刚强和活泼的信心的时候呢，患难甚至是能够帮助我们来去加速的传扬耶稣基督的福音。
It was evident in the apostles' ministry.
所以在使徒的事工里面呢，我们就能够清楚的看见。
When one door closes, they moved to another.
门关闭了，他们就会前进到下一个地方。
When one door closes, another door opened for them.
当一扇门关闭了，就会有另外一扇门为他们而开。
Paul testified here, you know, brothers and sisters, that our visit to you was not without results. We had previously suffered and been treated outrageously in Philippi, as you know. But with the help of our God, we dared to tell you His gospel in the face of strong opposition.
保罗他自己见证说，弟兄们，你们自己原晓得，我们进到你们那里并不是突然的。我们从前在腓立比被害受辱，这是你们知道的。然而，还是靠我们的神，放开胆量，在大征战中把神的福音传给你们。
My brothers and sisters, to conclude today's message.The reality is that we are living in a treacherous world.
弟兄姐妹，今天我们是生活在一个充满危险的世界里面。
Attacks and challenges come from all four corners.
我们看到我们的四处都有攻击和挑战。
While we are focusing on on growing stronger in our personal walk and faith in God, we also need to remember all pastors and all leaders of our church.
所以当我们专注在建立我们自己的信心，还有我们与神同行的生命的同时，让我们也要纪念到我们所有的牧师，还有我们的传道人。
Now Jesus said this when he forewarned his disciples about his impending suffering and death.
耶稣曾经在他受难受死之前呢，如此的来去警戒他的门徒。
Matthew 26 and verse 31, the Lord Jesus said this, and Jesus told them, "This very night." You will all fall away on account of me, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.
马太福音二十六章三十一节，那时耶稣对他们说，今夜你们为我的缘故都要跌倒，因为经上记着说，我要击打牧人，羊就分散了。
Friends, the truth that the sheep will scatter,When the shepherd is struck down, is still very real today.
弟兄姐妹，这个牧人被击打，羊就分散的这个事实，在今天仍然是非常真实的。
The devil and the world are attacking pastors and leaders relentlessly.
这个魔鬼和世界正在无情不懈地攻击着牧者和领袖。
Money, sex, and power are still the threestrongest temptations against every human being, and pastors and leaders are humans too.
我们看到金钱、情欲和权势仍然是人类的这个三大试探，而牧者和领袖也是一样的。
Many pastors, many leaders have fallen, and many more will fall if we do not care and protect each other.
我们看到有许多的牧者，有许多的领袖跌倒了，而如果我们不再去更进一步的来去关怀和纪念他们的话呢，我们看到未来将会有更多的会跌倒。
And interestingly, even as we begin in this new series, this month of October is also Honor Your Pastors, or commonly known as Pastors Appreciation Month.
那么巧合的就是在我们开始这个信息系列的时候呢，我们看到十月份呢，原来是这个尊敬牧者或者是这个牧者感谢月。
Now it is less celebrated here.Among Asian churches.
那么其实在亚洲的教会呢，我们不太庆祝这一个月。
I guess partly because either it is not introduced or because of Asian modesty, we do not want to elevate pastors too highly.
或许是因为之前没有人就是向我们介绍过，或者是也是因为我们亚洲人呢，我们有一种的谦逊，就是我们说我们不要太过的来去高举一个的人。
But nevertheless, it is important to pray for all pastors and all your leaders, may it be cell supervisors or even cell leaders.
可是很重要的就是，我们要来去为我们所有的牧师、我们的牧者还有我们的领袖来祷告，无论是你的区长或者是你的组长。
Friends, when our pastors, when our cell leaders are emotionally and spiritually strong, then the whole church, the whole cell group will be also emotionally and spiritually strong.
弟兄姐妹，当我们的牧者或者是我们的组长在他们的情感和灵命上刚强的时候呢，那么我们整个教会，我们的整个小组也会在我们的情感和灵命上刚强。
And the opposite is equally true.
相反的情况也是一样的。
When pastors or leaders become weak and toxic, the church will also spiral down in the same way.
我们的牧者和领袖就是软弱或者是充满苦毒的时候呢，那么我们的教会也会在同样的情况下沦陷。
So I want to encourage all of us this month to learn to encourage all our pastors and leaders.
所以我要鼓励弟兄姐妹们，在这个月里面，让我们学习来去鼓励我们所有的牧者和领袖。
In all the appreciation and honor you can give to your pastors or your cell leaders,Whether it's encouragement, support, gifts, or other things.
你在感谢或者是要尊敬你的牧者和领袖，你所，你可以做很多的事情，比如说你可以来去勉励他们，你可以支持他们，送礼物给他们等等。
Now the best is still to pray for them.
可是最好的方式呢，就是你去为他们祷告。
As pastors and as leaders,We need every prayer shield we can get.
身为牧者或者是身为领袖，我们需要有更多的祷告盾牌。
Pray that our ministries will be like what Paul spelled out here in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2.
你能够祷告祈求我们的事工能够就是像保罗在帖撒罗尼迦前书第二章所说的这样子。
We, being pastors or cell leaders, desire to be good stewards.Or approved servants of the Lord.
我们作为牧者或者是族长的，我们也是渴望能够成为一个神所认可的仆人，或者是一个的好管家。
We desire to be good spiritual parents to the whole church.
我们也渴望能够成为教会一个好的属灵父母。
We desire to be good parents to our cell groups.
我们也希望能够成为我们小组的。好的属灵父母。
We desire to be faithful heralds of the gospel.
我们也渴望能够成为这个福音中心的使者。
We desire to fulfill the call and commission of the Lord in our lives.
我们也渴望能够完成神在我们生命里面的使命和呼召。
And Paul ended this chapter by thanking God.That the Thessalonians were his glory and joy.
所以保罗在结束这一章的时候呢，他是带着一颗感恩的心来去感谢神，因为帖撒罗尼迦的信徒呢，就是他的荣耀，他的喜乐。
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 19 and verse 20, here these are beautiful words of Paul. And this is what he said, For what is our hope, our joy, or the crown in which we glory in the presence of our Lord Jesus when He comes? Is it not you? Indeed, you are our glory and joy.
帖撒罗尼迦前书二章十九到二十节，我们的盼望和喜乐，并所夸的冠冕是什么呢？岂不是我们主耶稣来的时候，你们在他面前站立得住吗？因为你们就是我们的荣耀，我们的喜乐。
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this is every pastor's hope and prayer. This is every cell leader's hope and prayer.
我主内的弟兄姐妹，这就是每一个的牧者，每一个的组长的盼望和祷告。
That they are able to say these words to their churches or to their cell group, that their pastor.
就是他们能够对他们所牧养的教会或者是小组说出这番话来。
That you are our glory and joy.
就是你们是我们的荣耀和喜乐。
So let us work together so that we can be each other's glory and joy.
因此弟兄姐妹，让我们彼此的来配搭，好让我们能够成为彼此的荣耀和喜乐。
Now in response to the word of God, we will sing this beautiful song.
所以今天晚上当我们回应神的话语的时候呢，我们要唱这首的诗歌。
And in this song, would you sing it as a prayer?For your pastor or your cell leader.
所以当我们来唱这首歌的时候呢，让我们也使用这首歌来成为我们对我们的牧者还有组长的一个的祷告。
Let us sing this song as a prayer for all our leaders in our church.
所以让我们以这首歌来成为我们对教会每一位领袖的祷告。
The Lord bless you.
愿神祝福你。